Well, hello everyone and welcome. Thank you on behalf of myself and my colleagues, Kathy Ellis and Jeff Runke, for coming out tonight and braving all of the winter weather that today has wrought. Whether that be to get your student here so they could perform or just because you wanted to listen to some good music tonight. Thank you very much for coming out. That being said, we'll try to get you out of here as soon as possible before all of that slush and rain turns into ice on the roads. I'm not looking forward to the drive home. So with that being said, I would like to invite down Trinity to tell us a little bit about the piece you just heard.
Hello. My name is Trinity Pia. The song you just heard is entitled, "And the Night Shall Be Filled with Music." This night holds the promise of melodies that will sweep us away on a musical journey. I'm truly ecstatic that we have selected this particular song for our performance. I believe it sets the perfect tone for what will undoubtedly be an enchanting evening filled with beautiful harmonies that will linger in our hearts long after the concert concludes. We hope you enjoyed, and the night shall be filled with music.
I felt like we kind of had to open with that one. It'd be really weird if we closed with one that talked about like the rest of the night. So I hope you like that one. The next song is maybe one that some of you are familiar with, but in case you are not, I'm going to have Alice come down and introduce that one.
Hi, my name is Alice Welchek, and for our next song, we will be singing the song, The Sound of Silence. This folk rock song by Simon and Garfunkel has a haunting piano to back up the singing and includes many interpretations over the meaning, one of which being the struggles with our inability to communicate with the people around us. Throughout the song, the sounds of our silence will grow louder, but we'll still have people hearing without listening. We hope you enjoy the stunning harmony sung by our choir, our incredible pianist, and I guess Mr. Sanders is pretty cool. Please enjoy Sound of Silence.
To talk to you again.
I'd just like to take a moment and acknowledge our great accompanist we have up here, Shirley Meyer, who, if you're not aware, is Jeff Runke's wife, actually. Yeah. She graciously offered to accompany us, and we're really glad that she's here and helping us make music tonight. The last song we're going to sing is a bit of a beast. It's 20 pages long. It kind of moves pretty fast, but it's 20 pages long. It was a really big endeavor to take on. We practiced it a lot. I really hope that my students don't resent this song after how much we have been practicing it. But they worked really, really hard, and they took this challenge and really rose to the occasion, so I'm really happy with that work. So I would like to invite down Shepherd to come and tell you a little bit about that song. Please enjoy the rest of the concert.
Hi, I'm Shepherd Boylan, and I'm in ninth grade. Louder Than Words was one of the musical numbers featured in the musical Tick, Tick, Boom from 1990, which was written and originally performed by Jonathan Larson, the creator of the popular musical Rent. Jonathan Larson wrote the musical Tick, Tick, Boom as a semi-autobiographical story. After Jonathan Larson's death, the musical would go on to perform off-Broadway with various different productions. Louder Than Words is the finale of Tick, Tick, Boom, and is a culmination of every single question that the main character has thought, what has made him do in the show, and what he'll carry with himself for the rest of his life. The questions that he asks can really cut deep into the heart of someone who has had a midlife crisis, or has felt as if they really haven't accomplished what they wanted to accomplish in life, with questions like, why do we live as we do? Why do we live choosing paths in order to minimize our fear of loss? And what does freedom mean in relationships when we are called to love? Thank you, and we hope you enjoy Louder Than Words.
Does it take an accident before the truth gets through to us?
Try to be honest when we can just get by.
Thank you very much. We're going to take a brief pause while we switch it around for the orchestra. Thank you very much.
I'm Kathy Ellis, and I thought I'd take a minute while we're rearranging things here to introduce myself. I didn't do that in December, and while I'm new to conducting here at LILA, I'm not new to LILA students. Some of the choir students there, I was like, whoa, that's Shepherd. I taught when he was really little. I teach piano and violin, and there's a lot of band students out there that I'm like, oh, I had them. So while I am new to conducting, I did bring with me skills for the orchestra to be able to improve on their higher registers and vibrato and listening to each other. And guys, you can come up now. And wanted to say hi, and we hope you enjoy the program tonight.
Welcome and thank you again to our 2024 spring concert. Our first song we'll be performing tonight will be Skater's Waltz by Emil Wonderful.
This song is usually performed during winter holidays, which is perfect for all the snow we got. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Our next piece is called In the Hall of the Mountain King by Grieg, and this one has been especially fun for us to do since of the progressively getting louder and more intense throughout the song.
We would like to give some words of appreciation to the parents for helping us start our love for music and the concert directors for making this concert possible.
In the spirit of Easter, I thought I'd share a little joke. Why shouldn't you tell an Easter egg a joke? It might crack up. Please enjoy Mountain King.
Next song is How to Train Your Dragon medley from John Powell.
We really struggled with this song at first, but we really improved. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you. final song is Kingdom Dance. This one is like by far my favorite. You recognize it from Tangled, I think it is. Yeah, hopefully.
We'd like to remind you that we're gonna have a short intermission between the orchestra and band concert to get things set up. We hope you enjoy.
Yes, they are awesome. All right, everybody up.
Thank you. Well, thank you for braving and coming out. I wanted to, his name's not in the program, but the student that did the great job conducting them through the warm-ups is Spencer Pia over here in the saxophone section. And he actually has handled some of the warm-ups from time to time with the band, and it's nice to see different students doing it, and it's very enjoyable to my ears, and it's nice to see their skills. So thank you for braving and coming out here. You know, we've had more winter in the last 48 hours than we got in December. And I've kind of come to the conclusion over the years that Minnesotans are tough, but we're whiny. We complain constantly. And I think we're probably the worst complainers, but we are tough. You know, here it is, right, hovering around freezing, 32 degrees. You know, if you're in Florida, you're putting on a parka. Students around here at LILA are wearing shorts. And that's not a joke. It's many of you, we're hardy. We're just going to whine about it. And then you get to a little colder, you get to 0 degrees, and if you're in Florida, you just die. But, you know, here in Minnesota, you know, you have to remind people not to lick the flagpole. 40 degrees below zero, and what happens? Hollywood disintegrates. It's gone. They can't handle anything. And that's when the Girl Scouts come around, knock on your door, and try to sell you cookies. So, you know, just keeping things. 297 degrees below zero, that's when microbial life on dairy products, that's when it dies. And that's about the time that Minnesota cows kind of get uncomfortable because of the farmer's hands during the milking process. And finally, at 460 degrees below zero Fahrenheit, this is absolute zero on the Kelvin scale. All atomic motion stops. You can't even get an electron to orbit the nucleus of an atom. Hell freezes over, and the Minnesota Vikings finally win the Super Bowl. So we're tough, but we're whiny. Anyway, our next piece is by George Gershwin, and it's from a collection of three preludes. This one is the second one. Of the three preludes, two of them survived. No one can find the written copy of the third. And it's been transcribed, and there are some recordings of it. But the second one that we're about to play is by far the nicest. And I think you'll enjoy it a great deal. The band really does a nice job of interpreting Gershwin. And there are so many soloists on here that I'll have them stand at the end rather than try to introduce each one. So George Gershwin's second prelude.
Thank you.
because we didn't have school or regular class this morning the way we were going to, we did not get a run-through to do this with the saxophone section. They're going to play The Lion Sleeps Tonight, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. I have not heard them yet play it. I've heard them rehearse it a few times, but they came a little early tonight. They ran it down, and I asked them, do you feel you got it? And they said, we've got this, Mr. Runke. So it's going to take a moment. They're going to adjust themselves. This is a student-led piece that I did not direct, but it's really nice. I encourage this kind of thing, and you're going to see a little bit more of it from time to time. But this time, it's going to be the saxophone section. I'm stalling for time, so guys, come on down. And they're going to play for you, and hope you enjoy it. It's the old Weemaway song.
Thank you.
it's really cool to listen to them play that. I don't know about you, but I'm really, being a trombone player myself, I'm very partial to the low Barry sax sound. So in that massively fat sound coming out of there is awesome to me. So it's fun to listen to. Hope you get to hear some more of that kind of stuff in the future here. Our last piece, before we play it, I do want to thank a lot of people. First of all, I want to thank administration for letting us have our concert tonight. I will tell you, I was very nervous about that. The powers that be granted us permission, and you're here, and thank you. Thanks to all of you. I also want to thank Paul Peterson back there, live streaming, and Tristan Ray, the guy who controls every aspect, our lights, our sound. He's done this before. He's been just so you know who's really in charge here. But I'm also very grateful for Jessica Reich for making the nice programs and getting everybody's name on them, and of course our principal Nancy Hawkinson. And Jennifer Richard, who's here. So thank you so much. Our last piece is called The Great Locomotive Chase, and it's based on a true story of some Union spies who infiltrated down south and decided to steal a locomotive and mess up the railroad connection between Chattanooga and Atlanta. And it didn't end well for them. They ended up getting caught, but it was really cool. They actually uncoupled a car and stole it. And made a run for it, and they got chased by another locomotive. So this kind of depicts it. This gives our percussion a lot. And they get to hit all kinds of stuff, including a brake drum back there. So listen for everything, and you'll notice that some of the percussion is up on top of things. So you're gonna like this piece. The Great Locomotive Chase, and thank you for coming this evening.
Thank you.
thanks. That's it for the evening. Basically, go home and stay safe and stay warm. Thank you, and have a wonderful travel.